Many incorporated small business owners have a year end coming up. An overwhelming majority owners have December 31st year ends, which, by the way, is the reason why accountants are so darn cranky in the spring.
Did I stutter?
But that's another story. But there's a lot of cool benefits to getting ready earlier and getting that conversation going with your accountant as soon as you can, even before or quickly after year end. This is my top 10 list for good reasons to get ready early. But first, if you haven't subscribed to this channel, you're missing out on free advice, people. Do you know what a seasoned chartered professional charges per hour? It's crazy, and I'm giving it away. I must have lost my mind, because all I'm asking you to do is like this channel. Give my content thumbs up, or better yet, comment, and even better yet, invite your friends to get this free advice as well. It's crazy. Anyway, here's the top 10 list for the reasons to get ready for year end. Number one, it's just cool to get it over with. Number two, you can use it as an excuse when trying to get your customers to pay overdue invoices. I don't know why, but it just sounds all official. My year end is due and my accountant really wants me to get these accounts collected. I'm sorry, like, blame my accountant. Their names are Swain CPA and they are absolutely in love with small businesses. Number three, you may be planning to reward key staff based on final figures, so getting those accounts reviewed will ensure you have some time to think about those bonus amounts. Number four, when books are nice and up to date, there's still some time to do some things to reduce or put off both personal and corporate taxes. And your CPA knows all these tricks, but there are deadlines. And some of these tricks start to fall off the table as early as January 15th after a calendar year end. Number five, annual financial statements that have gone through motions with your accountant are helpful for you in planning the next year. Going through the statements with your accountant and looking for opportunities or observing some weaknesses and discussing these with your accountant will give you that fine edge that will lead to improvement. But here's the thing, financial statements are like bread. They go stale after a while and are not near as useful for you now as they would have been at the beginning of the year. Remember, these statements aren't just something you need to do to keep the CRA happy. They are even more importantly going to help you run a better business. Take them serious. There are copious amounts of value that can be derived from an annual set of financial statements. But do it early or lose that value. It's as simple as that. Number six, want to suck up to your banker? Submit a set of financial statements to them early if you are required to do so in accordance with your banking agreement, especially if you've had a good year. And then ask for an increase in your revolving line of credit, even if you don't need it, because you never know when you might need it. And do this every year. Number seven, want to stay in the good books with the CRA? CRA loves folks that are engaged and serious about meeting deadlines. Now, I don't think they have some list of teachers' pets that they will keep track of, but boys, if you get on their bad list, life can get hectic. Now, sometimes slips happen, but if you have a good record, you can sometimes get them to relax the penalty if they can see that you've been a good player all along, but you can only play that card once. Number eight. Now, accountants, on the other hand, do have a list of teachers' pets, or I guess accountants' pets. And oh my Lord, do we ever love our clients that like to do things proactively. They get all our attention, and when your accountant is giving you attention, you're making money, or at least you are if you're with this accountant. Number nine, if you owe money or have a refund, isn't it nice to either get that tempting money out of your sight sooner than later? Or if it's a refund, isn't it nice to know you can dip into it? I don't know. Some people don't care, but I do. Number 10, this final point is more of an anecdotal observation, and I'm sure statistically it's the case too, but I can't confirm this right now. In my experience, there seems to be a direct correlation with the success of a business with its owner's desire to proactively get their year ends done. I mean, it's likely not the cause of the success, but more of a condition you typically see in people that take care in most of the areas of running a business. Being proactive about getting the year end done is just one other task that good owners take very seriously. And on the flip, the small business owners that are nonchalant about it, anecdotally, do not have as good a performance, because you know that they aren't taking something as important as this serious? What other things aren't they paying attention to? So it's just like making your bed. First thing in the morning, it sets the tone for the rest of the day. So doesn't getting the year end done early sort of set the tone for the next year? That's it. Now, go call your accountant now and get to work. Or call me. Let's chat.